due to the nature of this video. Viewer discretion is advised. My name is General Kenobi, and welcome to another Let's Play. Today, we are doing Fallout 3. Now, the Fallout series is a lot of fun, and Fallout 3 is the game I have played the most. It's actually my favorite of the series. What I do know about Fallout, it takes place in a post-apocalyptic future. I think each game takes place in a different part of the United States. Fallout 3 happens to take place in Washington, D.C. In fact, at some point in the game, you actually do make your way to the capital of D.C. And let's just hop right in. Start. New game.
Set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be complete. I don't set the world on fire.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
So there we go.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl?
So the game literally starts with us being born, and we need to choose if we're either male or female. Honestly, it doesn't matter which you choose, there's nothing, except for the occasional dialogue options. It doesn't really matter if we're a boy or a girl. I just like being the girl. I just do.
It's a girl? A girl! We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh. Oh, James. We did it. Oh, daughter. Oh, our beautiful daughter.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
All right, now we're going to pick our name. And I'm going to be choosing Catherine.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Right, now we are going to make our character model. And, yep, we'll be... Caucasian. And... Essentially, our face is good. Let's see, I do want to change the hairstyle. Turn around so I can see my hairstyle better. And we have everything up. We have pretty much every hairstyle you can want on here. I'll do the no nonsense. So yeah, not too much that we do with our character customization, at least in this game.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, beautiful, just like her daddy.
It's a big world out there, honey, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're
James?
Just a... Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
Please.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay? You
one day. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations,
now,
and there will be no repercussions.
The James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
This place will feel hurt
just like home.
It's just something you get used to down here.
All right, so we jump ahead
Come
1 year
on
later.
Here, sweetie. Come on, walk to Daddy.
Daddy.
There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, honey. I'll be back in a bit.
Alright, so actually the first thing I'm going to do is open the gate, and the gate isn't very secure if a one-year-old child can open it. But I digress. We're going to go over here to this book, and it's going to help us determine what some of our attributes. So the strength, is for lifting heavier objects. The more strength we have, the more we're going to be able to carry. I'm going to go ahead and max that out. Perception is that will allow us to see enemies that are on the battlefield. Endurance. Some of these I forget what they are. Charisma is never mind. Luck I'm gonna get rid of. I don't necessarily care for luck. I do want intelligence, because that's gonna be related to how many points we get when we level up. Yeah, that's. Yep, that's good. Wish I had some more points that I can give, but it is what it is.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
So that's pretty much all we're going to be doing as a baby. We're going to be jumping ahead, I think, 9 years at this point.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Can you believe it? She is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, honey. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
Congratulations, young lady. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
All right, so we got our Pip-Boy, which is pretty much going to be our inventory manifest.
Oh, man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
And this is Amata, our best friend.
We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Alright, so our dialogue options in this game will pretty much determine if we're going to be a nice person or an asshole.
Happy birthday! I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. That's not what I hear. But perhaps she'll set a good example for you. There's still plenty of time for you to make something of yourself.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go, a nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone. It's time to cut the cake.
Andy, wait! Oh, no.
I am mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
Enjoying yours?
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Don't you talk about my mom, you little punk.
Self?
You're gonna be sorry, you little...
Daddy, I told you not
should
to
should have just given
of...
me the sweet...
Boy, what are you doing?
Joking,
hitting
sure
a girl and on her birthday,
it.
For heaven's sake.
Thanks for inviting me
people
to your party.
Always
hurt you,
enjoy
honey?
My little speeches. Besides, that friend of yours could use a reminder that life is not all fun and games.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to... you know.
What? Is she your best
this
friend
is supposed now? To be a party,
hey, Wally,
you know?
I think
fun?
Paul's in love.
You should try it sometime, Daddy.
Yeah, Paul.
You might like it.
Why don't you enter?
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead. Oh, well. You can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Introduce us to your new girlfriend.
So, what do you think we should call
who
our
do
game?
You mean,
it's gotta be totally
here.
Killer.
Happy birthday. Hey, how about
I'm
those
sure
vault rollers? Get it?
Never suspected a thing.
Who wants to go around
now
all day being called a
vault roller?
Sometimes I think
enjoy
you really
yourself?
Are as dumb as you
thanks
look.
Thanks for coming, Stanley.
Come
I know
on,
you were busy.
I am mortified about the cake mishap.
I got one.
You don't have to worry about me and
super
Andy got
cool,
her all
right?
fixed up again last night. Good
jeez,
as new.
Wally, who's the head of the
I wasn't
gang?
Worried.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
For me? No
you
way.
You can fix anything, right? Anyway,
how do you like that there Pip-Boy, miss? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Having fun?
Hey, happy birthday, nosebleed!
How are you enjoying...
Nice party. I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
Hello, Officer. Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here.
Cole,
I think it's important to keep
open.
In touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job. Plus, well,
give me an idea for what to name our game.
Hey, Doc. Sure thing.
We're all set down here.
Well, it's been nice
Thanks.
Chatting with you.
I'll send her right
Thanks
down.
Thanks again for coming.
What do you got?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
All right, so we're going to be heading downstairs to the reactor.
Sorry about Butch. Your dad said we had to invite him.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
All right, so we're going to head down to the reactor. And here we are.
What are you doing down here, young lady? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
So in case you're wondering who that voice is, that is Liam Neeson. He's been in quite a few action movies. He has a pretty recognizable voice.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Happy birthday, darling. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
All right, so now that we have our first gun, we can start shooting things. And the first thing we need to do is shoot these targets. There's one. There's two. And there's three.
Careful, it's a rat roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot.
So the rat roach are going to be... They're not a really big nuisance, they're just annoying. And for doing that, we gained some experience.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter.
So now it is 6 years later. We are now 16.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, You have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
All right, so this is where we finally get some where we can actually learn some things through our dialogue options.
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test, GOAT. Everyone here in the Vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the Vault, we die in the Vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. That's not the way it works, and it won't do to go around asking questions like that, especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know, but it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have, because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, honey, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner.
All right, so let's...
Take care, sweetie. Now get out of here.
Let's get going.
Good luck.
And the first thing, before we go, we're going to pick up this bobblehead, which is for medicine. There are bobbleheads throughout all of the wasteland, and they will increase a specific stat by either 10 points or 1 point.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
All right, so let's get off to class, which is conveniently right around the corner.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch, why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Amata? Go run and tell your daddy on us? What's the matter? Daddy's girl gonna cry?
Let's go.
Yeah? What do you want?
What's going on here?
None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me?
If you keep messing with her, the Overseer is going to come down on your game hard. And as you see there, there's speech 45%. That means we have a 45% chance of this being successful. And successful speeches will get us some experience. And the speech is connected to our charisma and our speech stat. The higher our charisma and our speech stat, the more successful speech option will be.
Like I'm gonna listen to a little shrimp like you. Get lost, Poindexter.
All right, so that didn't work, so we are gonna have to get a little more forceful.
And who are you? Her girlfriend? Ha! Should've known. Keep talking like that, girl, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix. You've got to be kidding me. Come on, tunnel snakes. This twerp needs another lesson.
Butch, stop it. Leave her alone.
Ah, tough guy, huh?
I'm hit.
So we got our first little fight here. I don't think we can actually lose this fight. We just gotta rough him up a little bit. Point. At least I hope so.
I'm hit!
Hit her again!
Hit her again! Tunnel snakes rule! Losers rule!
Stop it!
Hit her again!
Stop it!
I can do this all day.
This isn't solving anything!
Get her, guys!
Stop it!
How about we head down I got to another one just like that in my other hand.
Great.
Tell them that!
You too.
Come on!
This isn't solving anything!
So I'm gonna try this.
Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time.
Okay, okay, you win. We'll leave the little girl alone. You're not worth our time anyway. Come on, tunnel snakes, we're out of here. Whatever you say, Butch, you're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine, let's go.
That got a little messy. Are you all right?
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Alright, so we lost some health there, but we can actually regain it right here from this water source.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has
to do. Alright, so there actually is a way that we can skip past this test. We choose this dialogue option.
Listen. I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you.
All right, so we're going to skip the test, which
all right.
Eventually we're going to end up here anyway. And I will go over all these in a little bit, but we're going to tag three skills, and I'm going to tag our medicine skill, lockpick, speech, and energy weapon. Yeah.
Did you know? Let's not keep the overseer waiting.
Right, so that's it for that, so now we can exit.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
Dad, Mr. Brock is here to save you now.
So now we're jumping ahead 3 years, so we are now 19.
Look,
you need to know
this. Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on, you've got to wake up!
What's going on?
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
What do you mean?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
Mata, what's going on?
It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my god, you have to leave now!
Are you gonna be all right?
Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving?
Negative.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
How?
Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
All right, let's get going.
Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
I'll only use it as a last resort.
Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Alright, so... Yeah, we are...
I'll meet you at the...
We're in trouble. our father has left, and the overseer is looking for us. And that's what we're going to be doing next time. We're going to be escaping from the vault and entering the Capital Wasteland. This has been General Kenobi. We'll catch you all next time.